A very good morning to all my dear lovely students. I hope you all are doing well at your home. So my dear students, do you remember what we have done in our last class? We have already started lesson number 7, the silly monkey, right? And in our very first class, there itself we have discussed the reading portion. We have read the chapter thoroughly. And also we have learned the new words and their meaning, right? And in our next class, that was the last class, we have learnt about I have just explained the whole chapter and we have learned the moral of the lesson, right? So can anyone tell me what's the moral of the lesson? What did you get from the explanation? My dear students, we have learned that a person need to be happy with what he has, right? And it's very bad that when a person turn to be greedy, right? We should not be greedy at all. And we need to be very happy. We need to be always smiley. We need to always keep our mind very peaceful. When we have something, we need to be happy and thank God that at least we have that with us. Am I right? Okay, so my dear students, in our today's class, we will be doing the summarization of the chapter and also we will be doing the textual exercises. Moving towards the summarization. So, my dear students, without doing delay, let's start the summarization of our today's lesson, the silly monkey. Okay, so please listen to me very carefully. Once upon a time, the king of a big and rich kingdom wanted to gain more gold and land. So, he decided to attack other kingdoms. His wise minister tried to make him understand that a king's main duty is to look after his people. He told him not to be greedy, but the king did not listen to him. While on his way to attack another kingdom, the king and his soldiers stopped in a forest to rest. Their tired horses were given peas to eat. A forest monkey saw the horses eating peas. He jumped down and filled his mouth and hands with peas and climbed back to the tree. As he was eating the peas, one pea fell to the ground. The greedy monkey quickly ran down from the tree to pick up that pea, but he dropped more peas as he climbed down the tree. He did not find that one fallen pea also. The king was watching the monkey from a distance. He realized that he was being foolish. He decided that he would not behave like the silly monkey who had lost to gain a little. The king returned to his kingdom with his army and enjoyed peace and happiness. Yes, so the story of the silly monkey taught the king a very big lesson. Yes, that we should not fight for our small thing and lose the happiness. Yeah, he said that we should not lose a little to gain what more. No, we should not lose very small thing to gain a small part of what we don't want, right? We always need to find the happiness in the small thing that we have, and we should not be greedy of anything, right? So he realized that he was being foolish, but when he watched the monkey, this silly monkey, the king realized that how foolish act he was going to do by attacking the other kingdom, because attacking or war never give any peace to anyone. It does not help you to gain something, but it always lead you to the path where you are going to lose many more things, right? Like he has said that the monkey who had lost to gain a little, for a small thing, he just got down for only one pea. When he got down, he realized later that he lose a lot, yes, that he had in his hands. So it's a very beautiful lesson where we have learned many moral values. The first moral value is that we need to be happy with what we have, and the next moral value is that a person should never be greedy. Yes, we need to appreciate what God has given us. Yes or no? Okay, so my dear students, that was in our summarization part. So moving to the textual exercises, right? So we have here few questions. First we will discuss, then I'll give the question answers to you all. So let's begin. Yes, my dear students, please come to page number 46. So in here we have four questions in letters discuss. So the first question is, what did the king want? So who can answer me? The king wanted more gold and land. Am I right? Coming to question number 2, who tried to explain to the king that it was not right to be greedy? So who was it? It was the wise minister. Yeah, he told the king that it was not right to be greedy. Coming to question number 3, where did the king and his soldiers walk the entire morning? So they walked through the forest the entire morning. Question number 4, who was watching the king's man from a distance? So the forest monkey was watching the king's man from a distance. Yes, so this was in our let us discuss part. So coming to the writing now. So my dear students, please take out your copy, draw the margin, and let's start writing. So the first two answers I have written on the board. The first answer of question number 1 was, what did the king want? The king wanted more gold and land, right? Answer number 2 of question, who tried to explain the king that it was not right to be greedy? The answer is a wise minister in the king's court tried to explain to the king that it was not right to be greedy. Am I right? Okay, so coming to question number 3 now, I'm just rubbing question number 1 from here and I'll be giving the answer here itself. Okay, okay, so the question is, where did the king and the soldiers walk the entire morning? The king and his soldiers, the king and his soldiers walked through through the forest the entire morning. The entire morning. Can you check it out? The king and his soldiers walked through the forest the entire morning. Right? Coming to question number 4, who was watching the king's man from a distance? We already discussed the answer. So it was a forest monkey who was watching the king's man from a distance. I hope you have already completed question number 2. It was question number 3. Sorry, I missed it. So coming to question number 4, I'm rubbing question number 2's answer and I'll be writing the answer below. Okay. Yes, coming to question number 4. The answer is a forest monkey. A forest monkey was watching, am I right? Watching the king's man, from a distance. From a distance, distance. Distance. Okay, please check out one more time. A forest monkey was watching the king's man from a distance. Right? I hope you all have written these 4 answers. So coming to the textual exercises, exercise 2, that is the literature comprehension. So what is the first question in the literature comprehension? It is, what did the minister say to the king? Okay, so I'll be giving the answer now. Please check it out. So So my dear students, coming to answer part, what did the minister say to the king? So who can answer me this? The minister said that, my dear students, I have written the answer here, okay? I have not written the question as I am having a very less space here. So what you have to do, you have to write down the question in your copy and then only answer it, okay? So coming to the answer part, the minister said that a king must look after his people and that their kingdom had enough riches. He also said that the cost of war was very high and that the king should think again about his decision to attack. Right? So in here, all the things were told by the wise minister to the king. Right? Coming to question number 2. What would the kingdom lose if there were a war? So who can tell me? Yes, in case there were a war, the kingdom would lose life, property, peace and happiness. Am I right? Okay, so let's write down the answer. So my dear students, coming to answer number 2. The answer is, in case there were a war, the kingdom would lose life, property, peace and happiness. Coming to question number 3, the question is, what did the greedy monkey do when he saw the pea fall? The greedy monkey climbed down from his tree to search for the fallen pea. He dropped all the other peas while trying to look for that one lost pea. Got it? Coming to question number 4, who was watching the monkey from a distance? So my dear students, I'm going to rub question number 2. I hope you have written it. So I'll write down question number 4 here. Sorry, I dropped it. Okay. Question number 4, I'm just writing down here. Question number 4. Who was watching the monkey from a distance? So who can answer me? The king was watching the monkey. The king was watching the monkey from a distance. Am I right? So moving to now exercise 3, value based questions. So my dear students, the first question is, what lesson did the king learn from the monkey? I'm giving my answers from my end here, okay? So if you want to write down your own answers, what you have learned, so you can write down that, right? So let's see what answer I will be giving now, okay? So I'm rubbing question answer number 3 so that I can write down the value based question. So my dear students, please write down your own answer. At least try to write down your own answers here, okay? It may be of one line, it may be of two line, but at least try to write down your own answers. So coming to exercise 3, I'm giving answer number 1 here. Okay, so let me write down, then you can read it. The king learned an important lesson, lesson when he watched what happened to the silly monkey he learned that we must be happy and satisfied satisfied with what we have. We have and not be what? Greedy. Right? So please check the answer. The king learnt an important lesson when he watched what happened to the silly monkey. He learned that we must be happy and satisfied. S-A-T-I-S-F-I-E-D. Satisfied with what we have and not be greedy. So it's a very, if I have to say, very, very important lesson that we have learned from the silly monkey. As I have told in the summarization part, that a person should never be greedy and he has to be what? Happy and satisfied with what he has. I have given the example of pencils, right? Cars. So my dear students, please learn the important lesson that we got from the lesson. Right, coming to question, I think so, question number 2. Yes, please check out question number 2. Was the king right to attack other kingdoms? Why or why not? Yes, coming to the answer part. No, the king was not right in attacking other kingdoms because war destroyed the happiness, peace and peace of the kingdoms. Right? Okay, coming to the writing part. I'm just rubbing the answer 4. Answer number 4. So that I can write down this answer. Okay? So give me a second. Few seconds just give me. We just writing the answer there. So it's the continuation of exercise 3. That is value based question. The answer I'm writing down here. I think so it will come. Just a minute. Okay. Answer number the answer to the question, was the king right to attack other kingdoms? Why or why not? No, the king was not right in attacking 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 other kingdoms, right? Because wars destroy what? Happiness, right? Destroy the happiness, peace of kingdoms. Right? Please check out. No, the king was not right in attacking other kingdoms because war destroyed the happiness and peace of kingdom. So a person has to always think before acting. Right? As the king, he learnt a beautiful lesson, an important lesson. He also realized that from next onwards, before acting on anything, he will think it. Yes, and he will just try to be happy with what he has. Okay, so coming to maths 1, my dear students, you have to do this by yourself. So it's very easy. It's a mental math, so you have to do the calculation in your mind. You don't have to use your pencils for this. Okay, the question is, the monkey has 18 peas. He found 11 more peas on the ground. Add these numbers mentally to find out how many peas the monkey had in all. Yes, so I'm not going to give the answers. You just find out 18 plus 11, how it will be and how can you count it mentally. Got it? Okay, so my dear students, that's all for today. So what we have learned a very beautiful and important lesson that the king to learn, that a person has to be satisfied, happy with what he has, and also he should never be greedy of anything. Right? So my dear students, few speaking activities are there that we will be doing in our live class. So it's a wrap now. I think so. You have understood it very carefully, very nicely. Yes, so that's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.